law firms that now have specialties in startups. And I definitely would recommend, if you are interested in raising money or doing a lot of contracts, you should look into the law firms that do have a specialty for startups, because a lot of them have programs, and the one that I worked with had a program where I didn't have to pay up front. So they really invested in the fact that we would eventually have an exit of some sort, and that I would be able to pay them on the back end. So I was able to get really high quality legal work from the beginning, which made my life a lot simpler when it came to hiring people, doing, you know, equity pools and sharing equity with my team members, and raising money, all the different steps along the way. It was really important to have a high quality law firm, and particularly one that had experience working with startups in the past. So that was one thing. The other thing I was going to say to your question was how I protected myself from, you know, in the process of raising money was I was my first investor. So I knew that I wanted to start a business, and in the 6 months to a year prior to kind of jumping out there and working on it full time, I changed my lifestyle and saved my own money so that I could be my first investor. So I definitely recommend for everyone, no matter if you're trying to start a brick and mortar or a tech startup, you should be your first investor, because it's hard to convince other people to put money in your business if you haven't invested in it yourself.
Yeah. Can I just say-